Hey, YouTubers, Mr. Complete Random here, and today for Top 5 Tuesday, I am giving you guys the 5 saddest Naruto deaths. It's my own personal opinion on how these deaths are impactful in the community, and it was extremely hard because many deaths happened in Naruto, and I had to pick 5. So just bear in mind of that. I would love to hear your guys' opinions. Who was the saddest death? If any of these you agree with or disagree with, let me know in the comments below. And warning, there are plenty of spoilers because a lot of these deaths are later on in the series. So if you have not watched Naruto yet, you have not caught up on Naruto yet, now is your warning. All right, so keep that in mind too. All right, so number 5 on this list is Haku. You get to go ahead and meet him early on in the series. You don't learn too much, but he does have somewhat of an impact on Naruto and a few other characters within the series, which is why I put him as number 5. He did have a lot of impact on the community, and I've seen a lot of people talk about him. Not as much as some of the others on the list, but I felt he deserved a place on the list. A lot of people talked about him throughout different groups, and yeah, so I put him as number 5. Number 4 is Asuma. Great teacher, great sensei, and extremely impactful for Shikamaru and a few others. I put him as number 4. I could have bumped him up. I was debating on putting him as number 3, but you will see why with the other characters that I list, why I put him as 4. I mean, I'm telling you guys that this list was extremely difficult, but with Asuma, he is a character that's extremely relatable. He has a lot of unique personalities, and he does make a lot of differences in many lives throughout the series. And he lasts a lot longer in the series too, which that is, it's very hard to have a character last that long within the series and then go ahead and die. That's why he's number 4. And number 3 on the list I put is Neji. Now, Neji was kind of a curveball. Not many people were expecting him to die, and with Hinata being a really big character, especially with being a couple with Naruto later on in the series and being the brother, you know, all that stuff. Neji, character that learned a lot from Naruto, thought that he had this destiny and had this just mark where that was the only thing that he was able to do was continue on the way that his path was given to him. And with all of that in mind, Naruto had changed who he was as a person and the way he thought, which everybody went ahead and connected with him on all these different levels, which made his death a lot harder to kind of accept. And yeah, that's, you know, I'm trying to get through these without going into too much detail, but yes, that's, I put him as number 3. Number 2 on the list, which some people might want to put him as number 1, and again, all of these were flip-flopped around. I had to work on this list for quite a while. Number 2 was Jiraiya, Naruto's main sensei, which taught him many skills and was huge in the series. Killing him off made big waves throughout the whole entire series, and I put him as number 2. Anytime I mention him, people start bawling their eyes out, and yeah, he was he was big. He was major character in the anime, and as this list gets more and more closer to number 1, I went ahead and thought, well, which characters had the most impact and which characters meant the most to all of the main characters, which is how you connect with the community who is just watching the anime a little bit more, and that's kind of where I put him. So I put him as number two. And number one is Itachi. Now, Itachi, if you don't know, is Sasuke's brother, and yeah, there's a whole story with him and why people connect with him the most. They liked him because of his looks, because of his initial background, his connection to Sasuke, his connection to the Uchiha clan. The whole arc, the whole entire story, the background with Itachi is something I don't want to go into right now with this video because I could go onto it forever. But people, as they went along with the manga and with the anime, learned that with him existing within this anime and then eventually dying by Sasuke, it was just the most heartfelt death that I believe was in the entire series. Like I said, this list was super duper hard. And you guys might disagree with me. You guys might think that there's other deaths that I should have put in there. I was thinking about putting Minato, which is Naruto's dad, Kushina, Naruto's mother. I was thinking about putting Conan. I was thinking about putting a whole bunch of other different people within this list, but I figured those were big within the community. A lot of people talked about them, and that's why I put, you know, those specific ones in that order. So let me know in the comments below if any other death affected you, or which one of those that I listed affected you the most. Was it Haku, Asuma, Neji, Jiraiya, or Itachi? Which one of those affected you the most? Let me know in the comments. Give this video a thumbs up. Let me know what you want me to do for the next Top 5 Tuesday, and I will go ahead and consider that. Subscribe if you have not yet. And as always, guys, deuces up.